The unifying theme of Scripture is the kingdom. And so when you understand that, and when the local church is built around that, because the church does not exist for the church. Far too many local churches exist for their local churches. Jesus established his church and gave his church the keys to the kingdom. The church exists for the kingdom. The moment the local church only exists for the church, it will become ingrown, narrow, and unfocused. But when it exists for something bigger than itself, for the purpose for which it has been established, well, now you've got something really special taking place, because the community will know and feel what the church has done. That's happening in Dallas at our local church as we have taken this kingdom concept. We've adopted 60 public schools providing mentoring and tutoring and family support services to the at-risk students in those schools. We're seeing kids won to Christ, parents won to Christ, but also their lives changed and shifted in a direction that will cause them to make better decisions as parents and as people, to develop a proper work ethic. But we've not only told them what to do, we've tried to build systems to help them do it. Whether it's our computer lab that will give them job training or GEDs or parenting skills, whether it's our athletic program, over 1,000 kids being mentored in our athletic program, or our summer program and the Dad's Club to bring men into the fray of what it means to be a man and to take responsibility for your family. We have bought 2 shopping centers to deal with economic development in the community. And inside of that, we have placed Christian businesses like our resale store to not only generate income for the ministry, but to give us a witnessing tool through business. And so we have all of these features just as illustrations. There's a pregnancy center where we deal with life from womb to tomb and surround the ladies with wraparound services for them and their children. And so it goes on and on and on. You have to visit us if you want the rest of the story. We'd love to welcome you here in Dallas to see us. But then through the Urban Alternative, our national ministry, we've taken the principles that we have developed in our local ministry of the kingdom, of discipleship, and of outcomes, and we have transferred that to training to local churches all over America. So churches all over America, either online or through our teaching team, are learning about how to implement these principles of the kingdom in their local church, how to train their leaders, how to train their members, and then how to do their outreaches comprehensively in all these different spheres so that they can have an impact. How do you measure that? Well, certainly seeing people come to Christ and baptized is a way you can measure salvation and the beginning process of discipleship. Also, building community in the local church, through small groups, through Sunday schools, but bringing people beyond the Sunday morning corporate expression into relationship with one another. So how many people are connected through the ministry that you serve or through the small groups that you have so that people are being bonded and are being reinforced in this kingdom mindset and this kingdom concept. So we're training churches in that. We're providing resources for ministries and churches. We even have superintendents from schools calling us and asking us how we can bring the National Church Adopt the School Initiative to their community and unite churches with schools for this impact we're talking about. You see, when you have to consider putting metal detectors in your hallway, you don't want to talk about the separation of church and state. You want to talk about help. You want to talk about who's coming alongside to strengthen our hand for impact. You see, if Jesus Christ comes back tomorrow, we don't have to worry about any of this. If Jesus doesn't come back for another 200 years, you better worry about all of this, because that's your children and your grandchildren. And it's not just inner city or urban anymore. It's all over the nation. This retreat from the divine, this marginalization of God and his Christ is all around us. So it's time to take a stand. This is not a time for private Christianity. This is not a time for spiritual CIA representatives or covert operatives only. This is a time to go public and make it clear where we stand and in whom we believe. And that's not just generic God. That is the Lord Jesus Christ.